What's up? Welcome back to online classes and have a pleasant morning to all of you. Now, I, Ajay Kumar, your English teacher, is going to teach you the new topic in prepositions. Now, we are going to learn today prepositions of direction. Now, what is the use of prepositions of direction? The answer is prepositions of direction could help you in framing the sentence correctly about the direction. With the help of prepositions of direction, you can frame correct sentence as if the preposition is coming in the sentence. Now let us read. Prepositions of directions give readers a sense of place or location. What is it talking about? It is talking about place or location. So if in any sentence while writing or reading, if there is requirement of talking about or telling about place or location, these prepositions of direction would be quite helpful for you. Now this can be contrasted well with prepositions of place. Now in earlier video, in previous video, we have read about preposition of place as well, and the similarity can be seen in the same prepositions of direction as well. So contrasted means have a glimpse of that, or it is similar to that. Now prepositions of direction include out of, across, down, onto, into, through, off, along, to, from, towards, over, through, up, down, etc. Now, dear student, I have also mentioned some examples for you, like better understanding. You have to solve this. Now, you can see example number A, that is, you have to go. And then, fill in the blank, the corridor to reach the auditorium. That means, aapko corridor se hokar jana hai. That means, through. थ्रू का मतलब होता है किसी चीज़ को पास करके जाना फिजिकली, राइट? नाउ सो हियर इन द सेकेंड फिल इन द ब्लैंक थ्रू विल बी फिल्ड. नाउ यू कैन सी शी ट्राइड, सेकेंड एग्जांपल, शी ट्राइड टू स्विम, फिल इन द ब्लैंक, द रिवर व्हेन वेयर इट वाज नैरो. तो फिजिकली अगेन उसको रिवर को क्रॉस करके जाना, पार करके जाना है, फिजिकली होके जाना है, थ्रू. नाउ इट विल बी शी ट्राइड टू स्विम थ्रू द रिवर व्हेन इट वाज नैरो, वेयर इट वाज नैरो. नाउ गाइस, वी हैव सीन हाउ द वर्ड्स कुड बी यूज्ड इन प्रीपोजिशंस ऑफ डायरेक्शन, एंड वी विल सी नाउ अ प्रीपोजिशनल फ्रेज. सो लेट्स गो थ्रू द प्रीपोजिशनल फ्रेज. What is that? And then we will discuss more about prepositions. Now you can see prepositional phrases, hashtag 1. So this is the part 1 of prepositional phrases. What are these prepositional phrases? Consist of, now you can see here, prepositional phrases consist of two basic parts: the prepositions and the object. You have already read what is called preposition, and now we have to understand the object. The object can be a noun. This is the identity of object. Object can be a noun, pronoun, or gerund. In prepositional phrases, prepositions are almost always followed by an object. So this is the term and condition for prepositional phrases. You can understand, prepositions are almost always followed by an object. So this is the mandatory, that all prepositional phrases have an object as a noun, pronoun, or gerund. Now let us go through this box, and we'll see there are three columns. In each column, a prepositions and object is written, and and the third column you can see prepositional phrases are also written. So when the preposition is on, an object is the desk, on the desk, all three words together will be called prepositional phrases. On the same, you can see on plus the phone, so on the phone will become prepositional phrases. Now you can see in third box, fourth box, at the park, prepositional phrase, at the stadium, prepositional phrase, in the morning, prepositional phrase, in the car, prepositional phrase. So you can see same, prepositional phrases for off, to, for, with, over, and by. Now let's have some fun. We'll go through some fun part of this reading, and that's why I have just brought quiz for you, so that you can test your knowledge, whatever you have learned. Let's start. Go to quiz. We'll see the question on our screen, that is, choose the prepositional phrase for each sentence. Now dear student, I'll request from everyone to do this work very importantly. What is that work? Now you have to read first the question every time. If you'll go or jump directly on the question, you won't get a more understanding how and what to answer. So please do remember, you have to read the question first, and you can see the question is written, choose the prepositional phrase for each sentence. Now what we have to do, I put dishes on the table. So what will be the prepositional phrase in this sentence? Options are given below. I put dishes. Now B number option, on the tables. C number option, the table. So what will be your answer? Comment your answer in the comment box. Let me check. I know most of you know the answer, so you can answer it in the comment box. The answer is on the table. Let's check it out. Wow, that's correct. Now let's move to another question. Next question, what is that? Choose the prepositional phrases for each sentence. Again, we have to choose prepositional phrase. There is a party at the clubhouse. What is that prepositional phrase? Can you answer it? Answer it fastly in comment section. And the answer is at the clubhouse. Option number C. Let's check it out. Wow, rocked. You again answer it correctly. Now let's move to another question. The question is same. We have to choose prepositional phrase. The students stood in a circle. So what is in this prepositional phrase? In a circle is a prepositional phrase. Let's click. Again you rocked. Now the first page of the book describes the author's profile. What is the prepositional phrase? Choose it. Of the book, the first page, the author's profile of the book. Next, the package was mailed to his boss yesterday. What is that? To his boss. Right, to is the preposition and his boss is the phrase, so both became prepositional phrase. Next question, she has been studying hard for the final exam. For the final exam is the correct answer. For is the preposition and the final exam is the clause, phrase. Next, I ordered a sandwich with a drink. With a drink, with is the preposition and a drink is a phrase. Next, The cost of the repairs is over a repairsman estimate. Over is the preposition and the repairs estimate is also phrase. So now it is, now you can see of the repairs. Now here you can see of is the preposition, but repairs is verb, and it was the, you know, like definition that a phrase, in preposition could be like noun, pronoun, or any adjective, not the verb. So repair here is the verb, so that's why of the repair won't be prepositional phrase. However, over the repairsman estimate will be prepositional phrase. So we'll go with that option. Next and last question: the flowers were delivered by a delivery man. Now, by a delivery man will be prepositional phrase. Well, we have completed the quiz and we have successfully attempted. We can start quiz 2. We'll have one more quiz. Let's check the answer. She is talking on the phone, with a phone, for a phone, on the phone. Next, John is standing on the door, by the door, for the door, by the door. On the door मतलब दरवाजे के ऊपर, by the door मतलब दरवाजे के पास, for the door दरवाजे के लिए, तो दरवाजे के पास जो है करेक्ट आंसर होगा by the door. I bought clothes off my money, by my money, with my money. मैंने अपने कपड़े खरीदे पैसे दे करके, with my money means पैसे जो उसके पास थे उससे पैसे कपड़े खरीदे. So the correct option will be C. Let's see next question. The water came up to the house. पानी जो है घर तक आ गया था. Of the house पानी घर का आ गया था. For the house घर के लिए आ गया था. To the house घर तक आ गया था. The correct answer. We'll see next. I'm staying on a hotel, hotel के ऊपर, in a hotel, hotel के अंदर, of a hotel, I mean of a hotel, hotel का, so in a hotel, hotel में, correct answer. Next, I'll see you for the party, at the party, over the party, party के लिए देखूँगा, party में देखूँगा, या party के ऊपर देखूँगा, over the party, I mean party over हो जाएगा उसके बाद, at the party. A place, a specific place, a party, and before a specific place we put at. I always carry a picture on my children, children ke upar, in my children, children ke andar, of my children, children ka. So kis cheez ka carry karta hai picture? Children ka. C option. Next, she quit her job for personal reasons. By personal reasons, on personal reasons. के लिए, personal reason के लिए, personal reason से, या फिर on personal reasons. She quit her job for personal. Option A. Choose the correct answer. The meeting lasted of 2 hours, 2 घंटे का. Over 2 hours, 2 घंटे के बाद या 2 घंटे तक, with 2 hours, तो option B will be correct answer. Now, we have since completed 2 quizzes and we have completed the lesson. I hope every one of you who has watched this video will enjoy learning. It's a fun, learning is a fun, and especially when it is English subject. Now, dear students, we'll meet with another part of this same topic, prepositions, in another video. This is video number 2 of preposition. One more video has been put on the channel. Now you can scroll and see about preposition if you want to understand more. Now dear guys, I'll now offer you bid goodbye, and I'll just bid you a goodbye, and I'll just request everyone to stay fit and stay healthy. Please do wash your hands. I will meet again in next part of the video. Thank you everyone, and have a nice day.